So let us get started. We will look at what is the problem that we are trying to solve. Then we will analyze how we can solve this problem using Heroku Connect. We will then learn what makes Heroku Connect the popular choice. Then I will walk you through an entire setup and then some points to remember, and finally the Q&A. So what problem are we solving? Let us assume we have a shopping website, and let us take a Myntra that we all have used at one point of time. And you know what? Myntra runs on a Node.js stack. So let us assume they have a shopping website written in Node.js and Postgres as the database. And this whole thing is running on the Heroku. Heroku is simply a PaaS or a platform as a service, which lets you run apps which are written in different languages. So here is the interesting thing. All the contact information about their customers is actually stored inside Salesforce. However, the Node.js does not know anything about Salesforce. The only data it can access and process is from the Postgres. Now, the developers at Myntra started pondering and came up with a solution. So we will write some sort of a job on the Node.js side, which we'll call the Salesforce REST APIs periodically and replicate the contact data into Postgres. Well, it did not go well. It was all fine for a few days and everyone was happy. But then they started realizing the hidden issues. The first roadblock was API limits enforced by the Lightning platform. Then secondly, apart from ton of code, they identified that they had to repeat the same code for synchronizing other objects. Lot of repetition. And guess what was the worst? What if someone added a new field in Salesforce and it wasn't real time either? It was high time they had to figure out a solution. Say hello to Heroku Connect. This is when they heard about Heroku Connect with lot of promises. Let us see what were all the good things that they heard. So what makes Heroku Connect special? Absolutely no code. The Node.js developers did not have to write a single line of code. Just a couple of clicks alone. Then real-time synchronization. Wait, did you all hear that? This means you make a change on a contact record in Salesforce. It is synchronized to the Postgres database in just fraction of seconds. In addition to all these, two of my favorites, that is two-way synchronization and Schema agnostic. This means you just do not have to worry even if you add a new field to the contact in Salesforce. It is all taken care. So let's get it up and running. I know I have been talking a lot. So now let us set this whole thing up. As I already mentioned, the folks at Myntra have their own Salesforce org, which stores all the customer details. So let me navigate to the Contacts tab in Salesforce. So here I have around 20 contacts. Now Myntra wants to replicate these 20 contacts into a Postgres database, which is used by the Myntra shopping website. Now, let me show you the website. So here you can see that there are no contacts displayed because the database is empty. So let us set up Heroku Connect and the database and see how we can push this data from Salesforce to the Postgres. So here you can see that I have my app, which is nothing but the website written in Node.js. And there are many tabs here. And what we need to do first is to provision a database. So let me click on the resources tab. And you should see an add-on section. So simply start typing POST and you should be able to select the database. Now, let me select the hobby dev free. And this is exactly what I like about every Salesforce product. You have a hobby edition that you can actually use to play around and learn about the same, just like a developer edition. So you might have seen that setting up a database was just two or three clicks, and this is what PaaS is all about. You do not have to worry about infrastructure or installing containers for Node app or installing the database. It's all just a matter of a couple of clicks. So let us take a look at what this database is all about. So let me click Heroku Postgres database. Now this should take me to the details page. And this is an overview of my database. So the free edition grants me a 7.6 MB, which can like support up to 10K records, which is good enough. So all right. So our database is now up and running. Now, what next? Now, let us set up our Heroku Connect. So let me go back to my application in Heroku and navigate to the resources tab again. Now simply start typing CONN, and you should see Heroku Connect in the list. And now simply click it. Again, let us provision demo edition, which is free. Now, let me navigate to the detail screen. So yeah, now let me navigate to the detail screen, and now simply click the Heroku Connect link from the list of add-ons. Now we need to establish a connection between our Heroku Connect and the Salesforce org. So let me go ahead and click the setup connection. Now that would ask me what should be the name of my schema in the database. Well, I will leave it as it is. And you can also notice that it automatically detected my hobby edition database too. Now, let me click next. So what just happened was that a schema with the name Salesforce was set up in my Postgres database. Now let us do an OAuth to our Salesforce org so that the Heroku Connect can show us the available objects that we can choose from. So I just clicked authorize, and now let me just log into my Salesforce org. Finally, click on the login button. So, yeah, thus a successful connection was established with our Salesforce org. And this is absolutely a one-time process, and you do not have to do this every time. Now, let me click on the mappings tab. And now let me click the create mapping. And now let me select the contact object. And I'll select the fields like first name, last name, and maybe email also. And yes, so let us go ahead. And finally click on the save button. I will now go and look at my overview tab, and guess what happened? All the 20 rows were synced to Postgres in less than a second. Now let us look at the logs to see what really happened. Now, if I scroll all the way down, I can see that Heroku Connect created a schema called Salesforce in my database. Then it created a table called contacts for me in my Salesforce schema. It then refresh the table to ensure that it is clean. And moreover, guess what? Heroku Connect, use the Salesforce SOAP API to download all the 20 rows, and it pushed right into the table. So now, what next? Now, let us go to our website. Let me just refresh it. And there you go. All my 20 rows are now readily available to my Node.js website. So now, what happens when someone changed, say, the last name or maybe the email of a contact? So at first, let us go back to the Heroku Connect and open the contact mapping. Now, I will hit edit, and you can see that there are two options for me, polling-based synchronization and accelerated synchronization. We will certainly not use polling, and let us check the option accelerate polling. This is actually based on streaming API, so we will never exhaust the Salesforce API limits. And now let me hit save. Now we will go to Salesforce, and let us open the contact Timbar and change his first name to maybe Tom. And finally click OK, save. And now I will now quickly open my Heroku Connect to show you what would have happened. You can see that Heroku Connect automatically identified the changes. And let us just refresh our website and see. So look at that. Tim became Tom. So that's about Salesforce to Heroku. Now, what if the Myntra customers modify their personal details from the website? So let me edit my mapping on the Mappings tab in Heroku Connect. You should see the section called database to Salesforce. Let us check that option, and we need to choose an external ID field on my contact object in Salesforce. Heroku Connect uses this field actually to write back into Salesforce. Now let me hit save. Now the Node.js site that I built will not only allow you to do inline editing. Since I was lazy, I did not write the code for inline editing. So let us use a tool called dBeaver and edit our data. Let me open dBeaver. So this is a tool that can be used to visualize your Postgres database, and it's actually free of cost. And now let me choose the connection type as Postgres and hit next. Now we need to fill all these fields. So in order to fill all this, we need to go back to our Heroku Postgres database. So I click on the settings. settings tab and click on the view credentials button. Now all you have to do is just copy and paste all these details to the relevant fields in dBeaver. So I'll copy the host. Then I will copy the database. Then the user. And then the password. And finally hit test connection. Well, yes, this failed because I need to ensure SSL connection to the database. So let me do that. Now let me hit the test connection. This might take up to some time. Perfect. So my connection was successful to my Postgres database. And finally, I click the finish. Now let me find my database from this list. So this is actually a big list, and hence it might take some time to load. So this is our database ID. So yes, so let me find it from the list. So there you go. It is actually bolded. Now let me spot my table, contacts, and edit the data. I click on edit data. So it's fetching all my So here's all my data. Now let me make the Tom back to Tim. Finally, I click the save button. So yeah. Let me just refresh it, my Salesforce. So yes, so my Tom in Salesforce is Tim again. That was so quick. Well, so that is all about this setup. So yeah, wasn't that easy? Now let's get back to our presentation. Let's see a few things to remember. So there are a couple of things that we need to remember. Even though we had a free edition, in order to implement this on a large scale, we will definitely need to buy a license. And the license is based on the rows. Then secondly, we cannot do any selective synchronization. It is either all or none. The speed at which Heroku pushes to Salesforce is 10 seconds, while Salesforce to Heroku can be almost near real time. If we look into the push topic object in source, you can see that. So yeah, let's just take it from the developer console. So yeah, you can see that the Heroku Connect auto created a push topic to facilitate the real-time sync of data from the Salesforce to Heroku. Now we go back to the presentation, and these are some code snippets from the Node.js application. And yes, so yeah, here are the references. And you should definitely try the Trailhead module and also the Heroku Dev Center. And I should say that the module is really awesome. And yeah, that's it. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Shruti. So guys, if you have any question, feel free to unmute yourself and ask the question to the Shruti.
Yes.
So I can see the comment from the chat window, and Dan Robin is saying Shruti is doing a great job.
Thank you, Dan.
Okay, so I'm able
sure. Hi. This is Dan here. I have a question. I think this is an awesome tool Salesforce, but the biggest problem probably most people have seen this is the cost makes it hard to implement and test. So I'm wondering if you have any experience with customers.
So then, initially your voice was break, so we were not able to hear you. Can you repeat the question one more time?
Sure. How do I sound now? Okay. No, I will. Maybe
so this is the database tool. It's actually a universal database tool that I use. And it supports Postgres and many others like MySQL, SQLite, Oracle.
Okay, so there's another question like, it is necessary that the website has to be on JS Node or it supports the other platform too?
I'm sorry, Amit, could you just repeat the question?
Yeah, there's one question saying that like a website has to be on Node.js or it supports the other platform as well.
Yes, it actually supports all the platforms.
Okay.
But the database, it has to be Postgres always.
Okay. So guys, any other question?
Hi, Shruti. One more question from my side. There is something called change data CDC in Salesforce, okay, which is like a data replication thing. And your use case which you took, it is also like data replication. So is there any difference between this Heroku Connect and data replication, or are they same?
I'm sorry, could you just repeat the question once more, please?
Yeah, sure. So there is something called data replication, which Salesforce mm-hmm. offers using CDC. Okay, mm-hmm. That also have a same use case like we have, you know, a web